Roll the 822nd paragraph. Just finished that. It said in the second paragraph in 820 that you have to condition yourself that one's movement of one's hand should not be reflexive. You see something. You're speaking about taking only what's right for yours. Not overcharging. Different things. So how does one take control that the movement of his hands don't come reflexively? That before you make a movement, you think. Even something which normally you do reflexively. How should one utilize his hands to do mitzvahs? And you should extend it, you should open your hand to give a gift to a poor man or somebody who's impoverished. But it's interesting, you know. The Torah could say, regarding tzedakah, titeh moni, give. Right? You should give to Dori. What does Torah have to be so descriptive? Open your hand. Lo siklo tziodecho. Right? There's a los asay. The poor man approaches you for tzedakah, there's posoch tiftach, and there's what? And there's lo siklo. So there's a negative command if you withhold, and if you give it, it's a mitzvah asay, positive command. It's being very descriptive. Pasoach tift, open your hand to the poor man. Tain money. Los sikbots, don't withhold your hand. Right? So according to what he is explaining, because the actual movement, every movement we do in the positive affects us. That's part of the discipline. Pasoach tiftach, the more involved you are, the greater degree you're affected by that action. That's the pasuk tiftach or losik pos. By withdrawing, that withdrawal has a greater negative effect than saying, I'm not giving you. Because there, you're doing something negative to affect something that should be invested in the positive. That's what he's saying. It goes into the disciplining of the person. He says you have to use your hands in terms of what will satisfy your needs. Here, you know, a person should be, if you're able to be a self-earner, you should be self-supportive, not to come on to other people to help you. So therefore, if Hashem gives you hands, gives you ability, you should be invested in providing for yourself. So it. To deny yourself a situation, we have to beg or take money which is not legitimate to steal. He says you should not be the vehicle for other people to do chesed. Versus, well, I'm doing the service. You know, other people are able to give me stuff. So I'm giving them a source. By me not working, no, it's nonsense. Yossi must told over a joke. Had a person, Mitzvah Goris Mitzvah, you know, the person served the guy rotten fish. He had that employee to his funeral. You know, chesed. Rotten fish, the guy gets sick, he had to be home. Eventually, he had all kinds of people going to the man's funeral. What kind of service he provided? Same idea. Exactly.
Yeah.
Sakhnis chuyoschad zulosecho. He says, by doing that, you're actually passing on your merits to a third party. And the chesed to the one who you were the object of the chesed to that person. A person should not be a burden on others. Just reading about Rabbi Yoshev, reading about it, that he had somebody, his driver, come early in the morning, pick him up, take him to his minyan. He was much older, So, the first night he'd be out of the country, he says, somebody filled in. The person came early. He says, he knew who the person was. He says, that's surprised to see him. So, he thought it was one day. He's not going to tell the person to go away. So, he allowed him to take him. Second day, he allowed him to take him. Third day, the person comes, he's not there. He already had left 20 minutes early himself because he didn't want to burn him. He burned him at all. And it was known he did not burden people under any circumstance. Unless it's something which he couldn't, it was impossible to do himself, he would do it himself. Wouldn't ask anybody. He'd take the safer out of the bookcase or whatever it was, he'd do it himself. He would not burden anyone. Lucia Lamasa Bari Odom, Moshe Omer Echel Minachom, Helokim Yirachim, Ebet Shaporas, Min Olam Loisa Prishuso Lamasa Alovov. God will have compassion upon a servant who detaches himself from the world without his detachment being a burden upon his friends. V'silik me'aleim torcho v'isasi be'ivor v'bine ha'mlochos v'shenemar yegia kapecha kisochel asherecha v'tov boch. The toil of your palms you should eat asherecha v'tov boch asherecha v'tov boch asherecha v'tov boch asherecha v'tov boch the Gemara says. You'll be fortunate in this world. It'll be good for you in the world to come. Even though the Rambam, Pat rules and Yichus Talmud Torah, based on the Sanhedrin, also Chelek, says that the Rebbe who denies his Talmud the opportunity to assist him, he's denying Yerushalayim. So the Rebbe is doing a disservice to the Talmud, specifically a relationship, a Talmud-Rebbe relationship. That it's beneficial, but the Talmud should accommodate the Rebbe. Right? No, because that's the best interest in the person. There, how does he, you know, it says he's denying Yerushalayim. That, like the Gemara says, you know, how do we learn God will shimush him yosem in the Udom? It says that Elisha, he washed the hands of the Yonah. Doesn't say he studied from him. So there we see, accommodating the Rebbe is in greatness to study from the Rebbe. God will shimush him yosem in the Udom. Okay? But what, here we're talking about a person who probably has no relationship. He has no relationship with him. Now you want to come. I'm going to be a birthday, I'm not going to be a birthday under any circumstance. This is a field. You have your black marker. What is that called? I come to you and say, you know, I have an opportunity you can make 1,000 times on your investment. What are you burdening me?
No.
You understand? If you understand, it's that minimally that. If somebody learns and is not wasting his time, he will not be a good lador. Talmud Torah connected kulam, the value of his studying has more value than you sitting and working for the next 1,000 years. Okay? Shachas ol. Chorus Ruch Olam Abba is more than the whole world combined. So, he's not wasting his time. He's studying. He's not going to be the God of Ador. But he's studying. He's utilizing his time properly. Okay, so that's an investment. The Chofetz Chaim writes in Avos Chesed, although the Gemara says in Subas, and it's ruled in Shulchan Aruch, you're not permitted to give more than 20% of the stock up. But for the support of Torah, you give it all away. Because that's an investment. That's Yisocha's rule. Hachzokas Torah has nothing to do with giving charity, supporting a poor man. Supporting a poor person, they don't want you to do more than 20% because ultimately, you'll end up with the person who you'll end up as in the position of the one you're supporting. Hachzokas Torah has nothing to do with this. It's not you giving a poor man to eat or whatever it is. There it's to having investment, a share in his Torah. So therefore, this whole thing, limitation, has no relevance to that.
I guess that's whether you specify it or not. If you're supporting public health, you don't specify that you want to suffer for it.
It's irrelevant. Even if you don't, automatic. It's automatic. I thought you meant specify how we should spend the money.
No.
Yeah, some people have, you know, they even tell the Talmud Chacham how to spend the money that they give. It's not enough. They're giving him maybe a 50th of what he needs. And this is called Yisovah's Wool in their minds. Yeah, that's Yisovah's Wool. You know? We're partners. Why are you partners? Because you give me enough money to cover my phone bill. Okay, that makes you a partner. Okay? It's not called the controlling interest. To be continued.
Sometimes they come with sheets, you know, I always ask them, is this for you or is this for an institution or whatever, you know. They say it's for me and my family, I don't ask any questions, they just give them.
Okay.
How many, you know?
Many of them are, you know.
They
put on like a costume to come around.
You know, but the truth is, I don't even have the time or the ability to evaluate all that.
You just give them one
so
glance.
You give them a glance, but no, so you give them $5 or whatever. It's not going to break you, but it seems like there's nothing wrong with that. Just indiscriminately. I'm not giving away my fortune, you know, and
it's not going to be 20%.
Right, it's not going to be 20%.